whenever you hear someone talk about DACA kids, those are the ones that their parents brought here, and we're going back and forth about what to do with them. If you ever hear anyone talk about DACA kids, tell them DACA recipients' average age is 26. And by the way, 72% come from public benefit receiving households. So you have to understand the facts. You have to define the terms of the argument. But here's the thing. These folks are good people, but they've got to have those public benefits. In California, when they're telling people to vote, they have signs in foreign languages that say, "Vote Democrat, keep your food stamps." Literally, and they say it in a foreign language. These are not bad people, but they're going to vote every time to keep their benefits because they can't make it here otherwise and they can't send money back home. So those folks, even if they're good, even if they're Catholic, even if they're pro-family, they're going to vote for maximum public benefits, and that's going to be the Democrat Party. So when we get to a majority, Mitt Romney talked about 47% back in 2012 of people on public benefits that are generally going to vote Democrat. When we, and a mass amnesty will topple that over. And what happens to you guys who the Second Amendment is most important for? You get outvoted in perpetuity on the Second Amendment, on national security, on every issue that makes you want to be a Republican. You get outvoted in perpetuity. Because when the electorate changes, so we have a majority of people that can't make it without public benefits or vote based on public benefits. So just understand that, and I hope that you will reconsider. Illegal immigration is the only issue that can beat us on every other issue. If we're wrong on that, we lose on everything. So, you know, I asked you to think about that during this coming year in 2020. I want to say very quickly about this local issue of the intergovernmental service agreement. This is so dangerous to the people of Fairfax County, I cannot tell you. First of all, immigrant activists, quote unquote, are jumping around about it. The ACLU says it's great. This doesn't affect immigrants. Immigrants are not affected by this detention policy, not at all, because ICE doesn't detain immigrants. Because immigrants are here legally, so they don't get detained. Illegal aliens get detained. I get the calls from illegal aliens that are detained, and most of the ones I've gotten over the years have been from Prince William County, because that's where they can get the job done in terms of every time someone comes in contact with the criminal justice system, they check on their immigration status. I've dealt with many a person that was called that way. I had a person who had a domestic violence incident with his girlfriend, and he got arrested for that, and they checked his immigration status, and they found out that he'd been ordered removed a number of years ago. He had to hire me and look and see if there was some way that we could do something. But that was a small thing, but there was no other way that that guy would ever have been found. Here's the thing. When Fairfax County says it's not our job to enforce immigration laws, it's also not their job to undermine and contradict and cancel out what federal law is. The president, by the Constitution, is granted the absolute power over immigration status in this country. His power is at its zenith when he's doing that. Thank you. I meant to have my clock up here, but I forgot. His power is at its highest there. The president has the right to make that policy. No one's asking local law enforcement to enforce federal law. We're asking the local law enforcement because police power is vested in the state and the local level. They are the people that are catching people involved in criminal activities. It's not federal agents, it's those people. That's where someone who's criminally inclined is going to have their contact. The federal government is asking, Fairfax County has asked them to continue to detain people for 2 days to give ICE time to come and pick them up. So at that point, then they get their due process in the immigration court system and they got a whole other chance to prove why they shouldn't be deported. But Fairfax County, and I'm convinced of this, they have an agenda, and that agenda is to change the population and electorate here in Fairfax County with illegal aliens. And so they are making Fairfax County a magnet for people to come here because they've said, guess what? You're not going to get detained by ICE if you commit a crime here. You're not going to get detained by ICE. And I'm almost done. Give me 1 minute. Let me tell you something. When an illegal alien gets detained by ICE, it messes up their life. I mean, they stop working, they can't earn money, they have to hire a lawyer, they have to try to get bond, they have to try to do a lot of things. And so for Fairfax County to advertise, hey, it's not going to cost you very much here if you get in criminal problems and you're an illegal, that is, I don't know how someone can call themselves a public safety official and be advocating for that. So we've got some danger ahead of us. I can't imagine how many drunk drivers are going to get released that normally, that these people, the drunk drivers normally would have had ICE detainers on them, and the immigration judges are not even granting the bond. I mean, they're getting off the street when they're turned over to ICE. They're not off the street when local law enforcement picks them up. So we have to make our voices heard. We have to get rid of this Board of Supervisors. That they have to go. The people last week that were applauding putting this whole county in danger just for their political agenda, those people who were applauding that, they can't be convinced. They can't be lobbied. We can make their lives, you know, miserable, but we have to take them out of office. So anyway, I'm sorry I went a little bit over, but I hope some of you now, maybe you'll move illegal immigration further up on your list when you're making voting decisions, because it's not an issue, it's the only issue.
Thank you, Betty. Great talk. Thanks for coming out and putting out for us. We really appreciate it.